प्रेम बोलो श्री गुरु महाराज की जय, उमापति महादेव की जय। जय सीताराम देवभूति, स्वागतम, वेलकम बैक टू सूर्योदय विथ योर श्री पंचीव जनक महाराज। अनदर ब्यूटीफुल डे इट इज हियर इन द रिपब्लिक ऑफ ट्रिनिदाद एंड टोबैगो। एवरी थर्सडे मॉर्निंग 4 to 6 AM रेडियो जागृति एंड 6 to 8 AM TV Jagriti. We join with you, Suryoday, the devotees, those of you who are looking on YouTube as well. Warm Sitaram and Swagatam to each and every one of you, dear devotees. Today we celebrate. What are we celebrating? Of course, on Saturday coming will be Indian Arrival Day, 30th of May, dear devotees. It's a holiday here in the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And dear devotees, this entire month we have been celebrating Indian Heritage Month, dear devotees. So this is very auspicious time that we take to remember our ancestors. So that's our theme for today, dear devotees, remembering our ancestors and the sacrifices that they would have made for us to have a better life, dear devotees. So on the 30th of May in 1845, the Fatal Razak would have docked out on the islands of Shagaramas, dear devotees, and the first batch of Indians would have came to here, to Trinidad and Tobago, and dear devotees. Since then, they have contributed in so many aspects of the development of Trinidad and Tobago that today we take the time off to recognize that and celebrate their victories. And yes, dear devotees, they are and there were victories that they made for their people, dear devotees. And why do we say so? Because we are remembering their sacrifices. Back in 1845, when the British would have, you know, recruited, and we won't go into how they recruited and what was done to bring those indentured laborers. And as we all know from our history, dear devotees, indentured laborship was just a fancy legal way of saying slavery that was abolished, dear devotees. And a lot of things were promised that were never materialized to those who came, dear devotees. However, put yourself now in the mindset of those who would have left Bharat Desh, Mother India, dear devotees, to come to Chinirad, as they call it, dear devotees, the land of sugar, land of chini, which is sugar, dear devotees. And when they came here, dear devotees, what did they come with in their mind? There was one thing that they had in their mind. They wanted to make a sacrifice to have something better for not themselves, but for their families. You see, the Hindu way, the Sanatanist way, the Indian way, you think about your families, dear devotees, and you always want better for the next generations and the generations to come. This is the thought that they would have had in their mind when they took that choice and sacrifice to come from the known that they known to the unknown, to go on that journey over the Kalapani, their devotees, and come to this Chinirad where they knew nothing about what to expect. Of course, when they came here, very poor conditions that they were given, and from that, their devotees, however, they still found ways to maintain their dharma, to maintain their puja, to maintain their satsang. They found ways and they did what they had to do. They kept faith, they stayed together, they prayed together. And a family that prays together stays together. You know, that's our motto at the Suri village, Shiv Mandir, dear devotees. Family that prays together stays together. We have that written very large as you enter the mandir on our billboard for our mandir. The family that prays together stays together. And so families, not only by blood, but Jahaji Bhai families, those who made acquaintances on the boat moving from India to, they stuck together and they maintained their culture. Not only the Hindus that came, but also the Muslims, they had to stay together because they were one people, and they had to stay together to survive, their devotees. It was a matter of survival. It's written in our history. Today we're not going to go into that. So they made the best of whatever little they had. This is the point. They had struggles. Life was very hard, way harder than we have now, their devotees. They made their sacrifices. They still made a way to pray. their Bhagwan, their God, and they found ways to maintain their culture, and they found ways to smile, even with whatever little they had and how hard life was. This is a very, very important point that we can learn this morning, dear devotees. So, this is why we remember them for their sacrifices that they have made. Why? To make us happier. As they saved, they sent their children to school, and so their children saved, and their children sent their children to school. They acquired a little piece of land, next generation built a little house, and so they went on and on and on until today, dear devotees, our children, they can be found everywhere. I always remember the late great Sri Secretary General Satyanarayan Maharaj. He always proud of, he always saw those little girls with their raksha in their hand as doctors all over the place, their devotees. He was very proud of that. That one time they couldn't have had any rights, now they are doctors, you know, taking care of our nation, their devotees. And so we have so many other, you know, things that we have influence in the development of not only Trinidad and Tobago, but globally, those who have made their sacrifices. We recognize that. So let us enjoy this beautiful song written by Param Gurudev, Professor H.S. Adeshi, for the 150th anniversary. He wrote this song. The Varsh, or the year, has changed. But this year we celebrate 175 years, dear devotees. But the meaning of the song, which the lyrics are there and the meaning is there, in the subtitles, dear devotees, very much summarize all that I have spoken about thus far. The sacrifices, going from the known to the unknown, traveling over the Kalapani, and making that sacrifice for their children, their devotees. Let us enjoy. Prem Saboroshi Guru Maharaj Ki Jai, Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai. Prem Saboroshi Guru Maharaj Ki Jai, Umapati Mahadev Ki Jai. Jai Sitaram, dear devotees, Swagatam. Welcome back to Suryoday with your Shri Pandit Shiva Janak Maharaj. And today we are celebrating Indian Arrival Day, 175 years here in Trinidad and Tobago, dear devotees, as we culminate on the 30th of May with our grand celebrations. And of course, this year we have had to scale down our celebration. You know, there were many great plans by the Sanatan Dharma Mahasabha to celebrate this 175th anniversary of coming to Trinidad and Tobago. However, we had to scale things down. And so this is one of our ways that we are celebrating here on our programming here on radio and TV Jagriti. And dear devotees, remembering our ancestors and their sacrifices. I told you, I mentioned before, that this is a very auspicious time for us to celebrate our ancestors. And what did I mean about that? You know, as we lead up to that of the 30th of May being Indian Arrival, the 31st of May, dear devotees, this year in 2020, will be the culmination of a 10-day celebration known as Ganga Dashahara, dear devotees. Hara means to remove, and so Ganga Dashahara, she can remove 10 sins, dear devotees. And you know, Guruji on his programming on Monday, Aradhana, he went through some of those, and we will go through them again on our special programming on Sunday that I'll tell you a little more about later on. However, this time Ganga Dashahara, dear devotees, was when Bhagirath Maharaj, he prayed for Mata Ganga to come to save the souls of his ancestors, their devotees. And their devotees, this is because his great, great, great uncles, their devotees, they would have been, you know, stained and cursed by that of the great Kapil Muniji, their devotees. Kapil Muniji put a sharap that only Ganga Mata can free their souls. And so, their devotees, this is how true Raja Sagar, he prayed to help free the souls of his sons. Then Raja Dilip, Amshuman, after Raja Sagar, generations to come, they prayed, and you had Amshuman ji, then Dilip ji, and then Bhagirath, their devotees. Generations after generations, they prayed to free their ancestors for the mistakes that they have made. And so, even though our ancestors have sacrificed to put us and to make us and give us a better life, their devotees, we too can sacrifice to help them. This is the message, their devotees. Bhagirath Mahamuni, he prayed and he wanted to free his ancestors, their devotees. And so Ganga Dashara was the time he prayed to Bhagwan Shiv. No, Lord Brahma told him that you have to, Ganga Mata is too powerful. If she comes down here on earth, she will destroy earth. So you have to pray to Bhagwan Shiv and he can ease the force of Ganga Mata before she comes earth. How did he pray, their devotees? He prayed like this. Umapati Mahadev ki jai. Umapati Mahadev ki jai, Shri Ganga Mata ki jai. How beautiful, dear devotees. Those of you on TV Jagrati enjoying that video, dear devotees. That is how he prayed. Bhagirath Muni, he prayed to Bhagwan Shiv. And Bhagwan Shiv accepted his prayer. Bhagwan Shiv, he accepted Ganga Mata on his jata. And so Gangadhara, he comes from the hair of that of Bhagwan Shiv. She flows, dear devotees. And their devotees, as he prayed, you know, very important point for our young people especially, you know, sometimes you want to get rid of family traditions, and this, it was his tradition, his parampara, to be continuing that prayer from generation to generation, their devotees, to pray for his ancestors. And so he continued the parampara, he continued the family tradition. But what made the prayer of Bhagirath ji different to his ancestors, Dilip ji and Amshuman ji and Raja Sagar, their devotees? What made it different? He had that bhakti, he had shraddha, he had vishwas, he had full love, he had full shraddha, faith in what he was doing, he had full vishwas, trust that he will be successful by praying to Bhagwan Shiv, their devotees. And of course, Bholenath is easily pleased, and so he was pleased, and so Ganga Mata flowed, their devotees. When she, Ganga Mata flowed, she freed the ancestors, their devotees, and she flowed on earth, and she freed the ancestors of Bhagirath Muniji. And this is why, their devotees, we have the Dasgat. When we too, our family members die, we have a ceremony called Dasgat, where you have to go to a river and perform the Dasgat ceremony, or that ceremony to free the soul of your own family member, their devotees, within the funeral rites. Dasgat is called shaving here in Trinidad. We have that name, Dasgat. Thus, 10 days that you go to the Ghat, the river. And this is why it's related to this Ganga Dashahara, the 10-day time that Ganga Mata flowed. How did she flow? How did she free the souls? Let us see in this video, their devotees. Prim se bolo shi Ganga Mata ki jai, shi Bhagirath Mahamuni ki jai. उमापति महादेव की जय. हर हर गंगे जय माँ गंगे भागीरथी हर हर गंगे. Bhagirath Muni, their devotees, as he walked, Ganga Mata, she walked with him and she freed his ancestors. And so, their devotees, this is why, as we explained before, the Dasgat ceremony. So those who had their Dasgat ceremony within these 10 days, which end on Sunday coming, very, very auspicious, and most auspicious it is, their devotees, that those Atmans are doubly blessed and even more blessed, their devotees, to have their Dasgat ceremony being performed in this period of the Ganga Dashahara. And so, their devotees, you know, it will be remiss of me if I do not remember, as we are remembering our ancestors and those who worked harder for us. You know, on Monday gone, their devotees, the 25th of May would have been my Mata Ji's birth anniversary as well, and her name was Ganga Dei. She was named after Ganga Mata, their devotees. So Gangare, Srimati Gangare Maharaji, that's my Mataji. And you know, even up to recently, when I made my little post on the temple WhatsApp group about remembering my Mataji on a birth anniversary, you know, it was mentioned that from others that, you know, they didn't know her personally, but they heard of her great singing ability and her ability to translate songs, you know, the Hindi and so forth. So she is remembered by even those who didn't even know her. Those who knew her, of course, they loved her so much and they miss her so much that, you know, this morning I would like to take the opportunity, as we remember her, I pray for her Atman wherever it may be. I know that Bhagwan is taking good care of her. I know that she's always with me. I am a slave to her genes, dear devotees. Many people commend my singing to in likeness to her singing. So I take that blessings from her, my Mataji. And so this morning, I'd like to share with you one of her songs that she sang and that we recorded. And we hope that you enjoy her singing as well as remember her, her sacrifices that she has made for me. And may Bhagwan bless her soul. Umapati Mahadev ki jai. Umapati Mahadev ki jai. So that's a beautiful voice of my Mataji and Pitaji, their devotees. You know, playing instruments there so many years ago, their devotees, maybe about 20 plus years ago, their devotees. Anilji, who is always with us and supporting me as well at the Suri Village Shiv Mandir every Sunday, you see him with his beautiful keyboards and sarod music. And also another departed soul in that particular playing music, Dexter G, their devotees, beautiful tabla music, their devotees. May Bhagwan bless his soul as well, and my Pita G's soul as well. And Majira, I was playing Majira on that selection. Now, dear devotees, yesterday was also our Dharmacharya Ji's birth anniversary as well, dear devotees. So we are not going to say belated birthday greetings, because at the Parshuram School of Hinduism, we celebrate his birthday the entire week. So we are still within his week, as he had that major celebration on TV Jagriti yesterday. And we continue this morning. We pray Bhagwan choices, blessings upon him to continue to be our guide and the person we look up to, their devotees, to take us into this new realm of Hinduism, into the new age, their devotees. And we have our highest respects and regard for him. Bhagwan's choices, blessings upon on him, as we know he is enjoying and continuing to enjoy his birth anniversary celebrations. He loves his birth anniversary celebrations, and so he continues to enjoy. So, their devotees, as we mentioned, before we close this morning, as I mentioned before, on Sunday coming for our virtual spiritual retreat, we'll bring to you a very special programming to culminate the Ganga Dashahara. We'll perform the Ganga Dashahara Puja, and we will explain the 10 different sins that are cleansed by performing this puja. What you will need for this puja, if you wish to join with us for the Ganga Dashahara Puja on Sunday the 31st, dear devotees, between the hours of 8 a.m. and 10 a.m. right here on TV Jagriti, and as well on Premiere on YouTube for the Suri Village Shiv Mandir, their devotees. You'll need 10 paan leaves, their devotees, 10 paan leaves, 10 asans, their devotees. You need flowers, you need your offerings that you would like to make, whatever little prashad or fruits or even sugar and raisins, their devotees, a supari, 10 suparis, rice. Make little heaps on each one of the paan leaves. You also need coins, agarbati, which is the incense sticks, diyas, 10 diyas to be lit as well, 10 agarbati sticks as well. And this is what you will need to perform that puja, dear devotees. So 10 items in all, because there are 10 offerings, Ganga Dashahara, to resolve ourselves from 10 different sins that we'll explain in full on Sunday coming, dear devotees. So, as we leave you today, we pray, Om Asatoma Satgamya, Tamasoma Jyotirgamya, Mrityorma Amritam Gamye, Om Shanti, 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 Hari Om.